Hello. Welcome to another analysis of question paper 2 and overall analysis of Civil Services Preliminary Examination 2018. I hope you are waiting for it, and it is delayed because of some other engagement, but definitely I am here to discuss all these paper. The question paper one has been already analyzed and we have discussed in the afternoon today, but after CSAT paper it is a very important to discuss considering the paper one, what would be the expected cutoff, and that I'm here to discuss all these questions. Keeping in the mind that the CSAT is every time some surprise package there, this year they have asked too many questions related to data interpretation. And that is a surprise package what we are expecting, and that I have already discussed in the classes that this year might be some surprise package will be there in terms of data interpretation. The other area which was expected, that probability and permutation combination will be also play a very important role, but a few questions were definitely asked from this area, but not much more. Instead of that, they have asked questions related to probability and DI. Instead of probability, they have asked questions related to DI many more, and that play very crucial role because for last 3 4 years they have not asked significantly the questions related to data interpretation. So many of the students has ignored it and they have not prepared well because questions of the DI they have not asked in last 3 4 years. So this play very important role, and questions were not easy even in DI. They have a very comparative study. They have given the questions related to bar diagram and cumulative frequency curve and even the frequency distribution. So that all these are play very important role and crucial for many students. And keeping in the mind of this, I can say the paper is 20% difficult as it is expected as compared to last year. And that is what I suggested and expected, and I told you in the classage. But because this difficulty level is increased, so many students will be in the boundary, and they will be around 60 and 65 in between. And I have worked with many students. They have called me today. Nearly 54 students has contacted me today through WhatsApp, and several hundred students are through Facebook, and many of them, nearly 150 call I received today from the students, those who have given the exam till now. And taking the feedback into consideration as well, I can say many students will be not able to qualify CSAT this year, and CSAT will be very big setback for them. They are not able to qualify. So keeping all these in mind, as usual, the questions, number of questions from the three different segments, like in English they have a comprehension, what they say that this is not English comprehension. As I told you earlier, this is a questions of the logical and analytical segment, that is a paragraph questions and comprehension based questions. So that's, these are 26 questions, whether in English or in Hindi. And maths and reasoning are 27 27, that is what the distributions last year was, and this is the similar like distribution this year as well. But the main factor is that the questions were not easy and questions were difficult, as it is expected, and due to this many students will be not able to qualify CSAT. So here the qualifying in GS would be easier, but GS also simultaneously not very easy. It is analytical type of questions, and many students, those who have studied, learn many questions, and the straight type of questions, straightforward questions or direct questions, they have not asked so many. Few questions were there, but not too much. Most of the questions are analytical and logical aspect. So those who have not a deep study or analytical study of the subject, they are not able to answer the questions properly, and some errors will be there. So keeping in the mind of all these, I hope that significantly the cutoff will be down this year. But there is one more thing which we can't ignore, that the number of seats is significantly decreased this year. So that will also have a great impact on the number of seats on the qualifying marks. If the number of seats would be around 1000 or more than 1000, then this cutoff would be nearly 95 to 98. But keeping in mind of all those things into consideration, the cutoff will be, as per my formula, which I had approved last year, very, very closer that I have given the perfect cutoff, that between 104 and 108, not less than 104 cutoff will go and not more than 108. So 105.34 was the cutoff. This year I can say, according to the same formula I decided and what I suggested, that cutoff would be what. So keeping in the mind of this GS here, 32 instead of 36 question last year was difficult, this year 31 question only considered in difficult category. 32 plus 37 is 69 questions, and these 69 questions are keeping in 2 marks for each question, that will be 134 marks. 10% for this year, I can say 10% for human error, you can say, and therefore 13 marks will be for human error. So instead of 134, if I would subtract 31, then that will be nearly 126, and then 20% around that for keeping in the mind that there is a negative marking, so that will be 25 marks around. So 101 it will be a cutoff, but because the number of seats is significantly decreased, so I can say the cutoff will be around 105, and 105 will be cutoff because this seat is 20% almost 25 23% is less, so 23% less, and therefore 23% less seat will impact the total number of prelims result in nearly 2 to 3,000, and therefore I can give 4 marks more than this is required than actual cutoff. Otherwise cutoff would be nearly 98, 99, or 100, below 100 definitely. But as per this, keeping in the mind, the cutoff will be 105. 105 would be sufficient, and if you have 105 marks, you can prepare it well and you can go with this main examinations. It may be that slightly lesser than this is also possible, but under any circumstances it won't be more than 105 or 106 maximum. So be cool and prepare for main examination. All the best, and if you have any doubt, do write to us at our mail, that is arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com, or you can call us also on 9999906400 from Career Strategist number. This is my new academy for civil services, and I am sure that next year I will be before you with some better result as well in the prelims examination as well as some main examinations. This year, those who will give main examination, and surely I am sure, very much sure, that many of them will also crack the final results. So all the best for the rest of the exam and upcoming examination. Be cool and try to prepare for main examination well, and if there is any problem, please contact us and we'll be ready to help you. Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless. Good night.